In 1954, Adele Balje entered her first contest, praising the virtues of a beer she didn't drink. She won. What she won, she doesn't remember, and no, she didn't drink the prize, but the win started Adele on a steady diet of contests.
I served my children school day breakfasts of good hot Quaker oats or mother's oats because I want to rate A in their doctor's report.
1959, her first big win, third place at a national Quaker oats contest. Her prize, a new typewriter.
And that really got me enthused. And after that, I just seemed to have a knack for it.
Adele always loved writing and wrote a column in her community newspaper.
I was thin then.
In 1964, she wrote 25 words on why she liked Seabrook Farms frozen foods. That won her a 10-minute grocery shopping spree. Her husband, an amateur mathematician, mapped out the store and planned their attack. The haul, $1,100, filling 9 shopping carts.
It took 45 minutes to ring it up and 3 hours to unload.
In fact, except for milk, bread, and fresh vegetables, it would be 2 years before the family needed to go grocery shopping again.
Blue cheese, smoky cheese, provolone, mozzarella, parmesan.
Writing about the shopping spree would win Adele a case of peanut butter and more cheese.
On some of them, I just felt like I was going to win because I thought that my entries were good.
There's no exact count, but Adele says she's won hundreds of contests over the years and a wide array of prizes. A trip to Greece, a year's supply of dog food, a new set of flatware, a Wheaties t-shirt.
Getting something to rhyme with Wheaties wasn't the easiest thing, so.
Adele's rhyme, before I meet with St. Petey, I get the Edies for my Wheaties, won second place.
You may be asking yourself, what about a new car? Yes, Adele did win a new car. A Porsche, in fact.
She's won a couple of things from WPBF over the years. This blanket is one of her favorites.
You just called in, and I was one of the lucky ones, and this was my prize, and it's something I prize to this day.
She still has the letters from various companies congratulating her on her winnings. So what's her secret? Simple, really.
You have to project yourself in the sponsor's seat, and you must follow the rules. That's the number one important thing to do.
At her peak, Adele entered about 5 to 6 contests a month, winning a prize in about half of them. She would have made a good ad writer.
Big, bold, beautiful, yet quietly elegant, Stratford creates a mood of warmth and harmony on my table.
Adele doesn't have a computer, which has put a crimp in her winnings, and she laments that many of the old-style contests have faded, replaced by sweepstakes.
In the old days, you had to do something and you had more of a chance.
But that won't stop her from trying.
I rarely send more than one entry or two to anything, but I've just been lucky.
Yeah.
And that's all I can say is I've just been lucky. Yeah.